minutes before we start. Places, I mean, the mobile market is already crowded, right? We have a lot of iPhone users and Android users. So what is it that BlackBerry is bringing to the table now? So we just released our BlackBerry 10 in the Indian market this week. So I'll go through what it brings and how you can create apps for it. If you see the right, if you use your any of your latest mobile phones on other platforms, you always have to go use a lot of keys to wake up your phone and find information. Yeah. Okay. On your regular phones that you are using now, you need to use a lot of keys to traverse to whatever you want to do. Like you want to know the time and all those things, you need to press a lot of keys. So in BlackBerry 10, whenever you wake up, right, there's a wake up gesture. When you swipe your finger to the top, you can see all your basic notifications and everything on your home screen. You have your camera, you don't need to do many key presses to have your camera on. And you all you have all your notifications, like your missed calls, the emails, the Twitter notifications, the LinkedIn messages. Everything is there on your home screen. That's a basic thing. I mean, if you use the phone, you can see that it's more like a curtain raiser event. The gesture can be, you can undo the gesture too. So this is a typical use case. You are reading a long email, and suddenly your LED blinks. That means you have some notification in the background. So if you're using any phone, you need to close this app, go to the other app, see what you have got. You might have got a new email or a new message, right? In BlackBerry 10, you don't need to do that. You just need to peek into it. So there's a peek gesture. If you see this, right? I'm in this browser app, and suddenly if I get a message, right, my LED would blink, and I don't need to close this app. I just need to peek and see what's happening behind. I can reverse it and come back to my app. You don't need to close an app to go to another app. That's very important. That's a reversible gesture. You can just peek and see what's happening, and if you feel that email is not important right now, you can reverse the gesture and come back to what you are doing. This is a book by Mihaly. This was done in 1936. He's the one who defined flow, the earliest thing to do that. Flow is defined as a mental state where a person is immersed in the activity completely. If you're doing some activity, you don't have to do something to move to another one. So the example is that the same thing. Like if you have a long email, you don't have to close the app to go to another app to see what's happening behind. So we let the users to immerse in their phone whatever activity they are doing. So this is another great feature. BlackBerry is known for its keywords, right? So when we have our full touch phone, these are keyword guesses that the keyboard throws. So you just need to select one of them, and you just need to swipe up. So if you see the finger, right, you select right, and it flows to your screen. So you don't have to type everything. So this is another example of how an app would be. I'll show you the peeking. You are displaying all your players that are playing the game. So if you have this LED blinking at the top, the red LED, I just need to swipe up to see what's happening. Now I know there is a notification, I have a new email. I can either go to that email or I can reverse the gesture and come back to the app. So that's the peeking and notifications. And even within your app, you can do a quick peek to what's happening behind the scenes. That's also there. It's not between apps, it's also within the apps. It always follows your finger, and it can be canceled. The gesture can be canceled. So there's also a context menu within an app. This helps you to do within context if you want to do something, like if you have a new phone call, if you want to add it to your phone book. All those things would come in context. Within the context, if you want to do, there's a context menu, and it's provided by the platform. So you can compare players and all those things. They come within context. And cards, this is another important functionality. Like if you have an app and if you want to bring functionality from another app, you don't have to close this app and go there. You can implement a card and bring the functionality of that app to this app. So you get the whole screen, and whenever you close the card, you come back to your app. So all the BlackBerry 10 apps, they are integrated, they are social, and they are also beautiful. So this is what Mark Weiser, the father of ubiquitous computing, told about what it is. The technology is right. They have to weave into your everyday fabric. You shouldn't feel that you are using something and you need to learn something to do it. So it's not just the phone. We want to bring that experience to other devices. So we want to have this technology spread across the devices. So this is an example of cloud computing where the car consoles are powered by BlackBerry 10. I have a video on this. I don't know if you can hear the audio.
What it does, based on BlackBerry 10, is it has a telematic unit, it has the dashboard, it has screens in the back, for example, for video conferencing or for gaming. Now, these are not four different devices. They're all run from one single mobile computing platform, which is BlackBerry 10. That is the power of BlackBerry 10. That is the purpose of BlackBerry 10.
If you see that, right, all the consoles and even the dashboard, everything is powered by a BlackBerry 10 device. So, how do we program for BlackBerry 10? There are a lot of ways you can program for BlackBerry 10. We have the native environment where you can use Cascades. You can do it in C++. You have HTML5, and our HTML5 environment. The tools which we use, they are coming under Apache, and we also have Android framework where you can bring your Android apps. About 90% of your Android apps can be ported to BlackBerry 10, and they can run as is. And we also have Adobe Air, if you have an Air app, you can bring it here. And all the tools, the app vendor ID and everything are free, so there's no cost for any of the developers. So all the resources are here, developer.blackberry.com. So the native framework, native is built on QNX. QNX is the operating system that powers multiple platforms. They are used in nuclear reactors, in space shuttles, everywhere. So we use the same OS for BlackBerry 10. It's microkernel based. It's also POSIX compliant. The C++ is the basic programming language you use there. We have device deployment tools. We have simulator images which you can use to program. The IDE is based out of based on Eclipse. There are also tools for doing profiling, debugging, and memory analysis. And the Visual Studio plugin is also coming. We also have this HTML5 platform where if you are a web programmer, if you want to bring your app, you can do that. Ripple Emulator is Chrome-based. It's been incubated under Apache. It would support other devices as well. It would support iOS, Android devices as well. So if you program on using Ripple, you can build your apps for other devices as well. It's open source. So our HTML browser is the best in the industry. It scores around 484, so it's the top browser right now. So we want it to be like that. So if you have any questions, I would like to take them.
Are there any cheaper phones coming on?
Yes, they are planned over the year. We'd have mid-range and low-end phones as well.
Okay, this is a question probably a lot of us are thinking. I'm an Android developer.
Yeah.
What is my incentive to be on BlackBerry?
See, it's about reaching to other users, right? I mean, BlackBerry has a lot of user base.
Really?
So, yeah. I mean, BlackBerry 10 as of now is best selling in UK and Canada. So, we haven't released in other markets. India, we just released this week. So, you'll know the figures once they announce it, how many they sell. So, if you want to reach all the user base, you need to develop for BlackBerry. And our development environment is the best right now in the industry. If you see the HTML5 score, right? We are the best. So if you want to try on the latest tools, yeah, you should come and try on BlackBerry.
For developing, we are supposed to use an Eclipse
plugin? For the native, yes. For WebWorks, if you are doing HTML5, you can use our Ripple tool. It's being incubated under Apache, so it's free. If you program using Ripple, you can also test it for various other devices and build the app for them. You can do it for iOS as well as Android devices as well.
You have a Java API?
BlackBerry 10 doesn't support Java API. It supports only the Android runtime. So if you have an Android app, you can just you just need 5 minutes of your time to bring that app to BlackBerry 10. You just need to convert, repackage it to BlackBerry and run it here.
You have an application written in Qt framework.
Yeah.
So does it easily get ported to BlackBerry?
Yes. Except for the UI, the UI is Cascades now. We did our own UI. Other than that, the rest of the Qt APIs are there. So if you want to use a Cascades UI, you need to redo the UI part. Other than that, there are no changes.
Under the programming guide, you mentioned Adobe AIR.
Yeah.
What is that? Can you look?
Adobe platform, lot of games are built using Adobe AIR framework. So if you are a game programmer and using that, that platform is supported too.
So it's basically for games only?
Mostly it's used for games.
Is there any relation between Adobe layer or?
No.
Adobe AIR?
No. Any other questions? Okay, good. If you want, you can try the phone. I have a BB10 with me. Yeah, thank you.
Z10.
Yeah, Z10, yeah.
Do you have an emulator you could show us?
Yep. So it runs under VMware. You just need to install the VMware player. You can download from the developer website. So we have the Ripple emulator. This is based on Chrome. You can do that for any website. You can check it out. We have the WebWorks SDK. That's the one that would package your app to BlackBerry platform. And the Android one, Android, we have an online tool that would convert your Android APK to a bar file. Bar is our archive file which you submit to the app world. So if you see the repackaging tools, we have both the online tool as well as the offline tool. And you can also have your Eclipse plugin that would package your app there for your So you just need to submit your, for the online tool, you just need to submit your APK and that would convert and give you the bar file back. You can also sign the app using that. So there are also command line tools to do that. See, the BlackBerry 7 devices, right, 5, 6, 7, they are based on Java JTME framework. With BlackBerry 10, they have redesigned everything. They thought what they should do for the next 10 years, how their programming environment should look like. So they started with building on QNX. So now the native programming environment is C++. There is no Java in it now. So the only Java you get is the Android runtime is supported. So if you have an Android app to run it on this platform, that's when the Android the Java runtime is supported. Other than that, there's no Java programming now. So it's the JAD, whatever you're talking about. So the parallel to that, what we do now in BlackBerry 10 is called BAR, BlackBerry Archive. It's called, it's short for BlackBerry Archive.
So it will have a single.
Yeah, it's a single file. Yeah.
What do you think if the app is written in Android and it's converted for this framework?
Yeah.
Will it be better implemented in this for this OS as such, or writing an app especially for this OS? What is the better deal to go?
Obviously, if you are having an Android runtime app, right? So it uses the runtime, so it would be a little slow, and you are not using the native features to do that. So the user experience would be a little less, and also it would be a little slow. But if you don't have time to redo an app, and if you're short of resources, that's easy of bringing your app there. But if you're keen on having a better experience and make it faster, right, so you have to go for native. I mean, that's true for any platform.
So what is the core platform changes when compared to the old BlackBerry versions?
That's what I was telling, right? The old BlackBerry 5 to 7, they are based on JTME. So those are the CLDC framework, right? Those are meant for early generation mobile phones. I mean, the CLDC stands for limited devices, right? So when we started building for BlackBerry 10, we thought that the devices are no longer limited. So we wanted to be a complete mobile platform, complete platform as such, rather than a limited device. So we wanted to have all the features. Even a HTML5, right? If you see, the apps are as, you can have better experience now. So, yeah.
So how many apps is now in BlackBerry Store?
For BlackBerry 10, we have more than 100K.
So that means the previous BlackBerry app does not come to BlackBerry 10?
No.
Does not.
No, they won't come. Yeah. So you have to redo them. Yeah.
Oh, my God.
So for developers who have primarily a Java background and not a C++ background, then probably developing for Android and then porting it this way is the...
Yeah, that's the easier thing, yeah. That's a shortcut. But if you are a Java programmer, coming to C++ wouldn't be that difficult.
Yeah.
Java is more limited than C++, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that means store for the application for BlackBerry 10 is also different?
Yeah. No, it's the same store. From the same store, whenever you connect from your device, right, the BlackBerry world will show only BlackBerry 10 applications here. That would show 7 applications there. So for the same app, you can have both the Java version as well as the BB10 version. Yeah.
So Earlier in 5, 6, 7, there are lots of memory management issues. At least, has this been recovered in BlackBerry 10?
Yeah, BlackBerry 10, you need to do it yourself. Each app, right, it runs it in its own sandbox. So there are limitations in which what the app can do. So most of them are handled, but you need to unlock yourselves. So it's a C++ program. Yeah.
How many apps?
Me? I developed couple.
So is there any negative feedback about BlackBerry 10?
As of now, no. The apps are still not, all of the apps that we promised, they are still not there. Like Skype is, it's coming in a couple of weeks. So those kind of market feedbacks are there, but other than that, the platform-wise, it's supposed to be the best at the moment.
So how about the hardware configs when compared to the old BlackBerry? So what is the minimum requirement that your BlackBerry should accept? Say if I create a in Android, it doesn't matter. It supports even 2.2 and lower versions, whatever app it may be. So in that case, if I say the BlackBerry, old BlackBerry is BlackBerry 7 to 6 to 9 or something. So even though I rewrite them, so
is
there any
lag
or something?
No. This is a completely new platform, so there is no legacy here. So whatever you are building, it's fresh.
It means now BlackBerry is now a smartphone.
Yeah. I mean, it's a smartphone from the first year. So it got smarter.
Yeah.
Is there any BlackBerry device which could be upgradable to BlackBerry 10, or it's completely new?
It's completely new. Yeah, the playbooks, they will be upgradable to BB10.
BlackBerry playbook can be upgraded.
Yeah, upgraded. Yeah, but it's not right now. But it will happen over this year. Yeah, but the old BlackBerry devices, the QWERTY ones, they will not be upgraded.
Now only the Z10 is released, but
yeah.
The QWERTY edition is not released in India.
The QWERTY it's not released worldwide, QWERTY. It will be available in a couple of months, maybe April, May time frame. So.
Darol, has it been launched?
It's launched in UK and Canada, and India we launched just this week. So. All other APAC countries will follow, and US will be happen next month. March this month. Yeah.
How about the Indian language
support? Indian language, the input is not supported right now. Input will come in 10.2 release. That would happen in a couple of months. But output, right? If you want to see the language, yeah, you can see it in. You can see all southern languages: Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, Malayalam. And we also have support for Hindi, Gujarati, Punjabi, Bengali.
Okay.